Hi, my name is Inder and this video is on software test reporting. Software test report is the report on your testing activities. Now, the benefit of having a software test report is to communicate system quality and the testing status to the stakeholders in your project or the team. Now, software test reports are of different types. Either it can be an individual test report which you produce as a tester, or it can be the team test report that is made by consolidating the data from all the individual testers in the team. Also, the software test report can be a daily report or a final report. When the testing cycle is going on, that time you can produce a daily report. And when the testing is finished, it's the last day of testing and you have done the final testing, then you can produce the final report. Now, the software test report should contain all the data that is required in order for the stakeholders or the team to understand the current testing status. So, some data that you can give in the software test report are the project name or a brief project overview, the types of testing that you have done, whether it is functional testing or performance testing or security testing or usability testing or any other type of testing. The important data in the software test report is the status of the tests. So what tests are complete, what are in progress, and what are still pending. You can also give an important data about the feature status that you are testing, what is the status of each individual feature. And finally, you can give the bug tracking data, how many bugs are logged, how many are closed, and how many are still open. So this, let us go to an example software test status report. And here what we can see is that it contains the placeholders. So it is basically a template or a format that you can use. You can use it both as an individual status report or and also as a team status report. The difference being, as I already mentioned, that the individual status report is going to contain the data for the individual tester and the team status report is going to contain the data for the entire team of testers. So let us take a look at this sample template that we have over here. So it is the test report and you can mention the project name. In fact, you can customize it according to your requirements. It is possible to generate the software test report either by hand by using the template and filling up all the required data, or you can run queries on your test management software and produce this software test report automatically. Then there is test cycle, so you can mention what type of testing this report is all about, so whether it is functional testing or performance testing or any other type of testing. And you can give the test cycle number, whether it's a test cycle number 1, 2, or whatever test cycle number is there. Then out of the executed test cases, you can give how many test cases passed. You can mention the number of passed test cases over here, how many test cases failed, and the sum of the passed and failed is the total number of tests that have been executed. So let us fill up this report just as an example. So let us say you executed a total of 50 test cases and 45 test cases passed and 5 test cases failed. So that makes a total of tests executed passed plus failed as 50. And other than that, there may be other test cases which are in progress. So let us say 10 tests are currently being executed and other 20 test cases are pending, and we can say a couple of test cases are blocked. So it's a total of 82 test cases that are going to be executed in the current test cycle. Then you can give the summary of the quality of each of the feature or components that you are testing. So you can mention the name of the feature or the component, how many tests were planned to test that feature, then percent tests executed, percent tests passed, and percent deferred or blocked. Deferred means that the test is going to be carried out at a later time, and blocked means due to some problem with the system, you are unable to execute that particular test. And you can give the overall status of the feature, whether it is okay, So you can give color coding also. You can give the status as green if it is okay. If it is a feature with some problems, you can give the color as yellow. Or if it is a feature with lot of problems, lot of defects, you can give the status in the red color code. And also you can mention the observations for that feature, whether it is working okay or it has a few problems or there are major quality issues with that feature. Then you can give the defect summary data. So here are the different severities: critical, high, medium and low. Again, each row is color coded. And for the critical defects, how many defects were logged out of all the defects that were logged? What percentage of defects are already closed by the developers? What percentage of the defects were invalid? And what percentage of the defects are still open? So overall, the test status report should give objective data to the stakeholders and the team as to the current status of the testing and current status of the assessment of the system quality. So depending on what is the important data that your team asks about, you can include that in your test status report, so that when you share the status report, whether you share it electronically by email or post it to your internal website, or you just discuss it in the meeting, you are able to communicate effectively to the stakeholders and the team what is the current status of testing and what is the your current assessment of the system quality. So that is about the test report in software testing, and thank you for viewing this video, and see you in the next one.